So, Fubo was up almost 30% today, maybe even a little bit more. And why? Well, because they reported earnings. So, as you would expect, earnings were sensational. Better than average, better than good. I said sensational. They were great. I'm very impressed with the numbers. I hope you are too. But we're about to break it down. We're fixing to be talking about Fubo. We're going to be talking about what you should expect going forward. And I've got a special surprise guest for you today. This is a time when you would expect everybody to be very excited, very bullish on Fubo. But, we still got Rich Greenfield that seems to want to hate like a little whiny baby because Fubo never hit his $8 price target as he predicted it would. And when that didn't happen, he adjusted his price target to $6 and said, yeah, Fubo's gonna hit $6. Now, of course, in his defense, I mean, that's the only reasonable thing left to do. If it doesn't hit your $8 price target and, happens to say much higher above that $8 price target, the only reasonable thing to do is set a $6 price target, because if the $8 price target never hits, then the $6 price target is bound to hit eventually, right? Only if you're an idiot and you don't know what in the hell you're talking about. But hey, that's just Rich Greenfield for you. That guy, he may be a moron, but don't tell him I said so, because he already blocked me from Twitter. And, it broke my heart, but I really don't give a rat's behind because I don't care about morons. I mean, how humiliating, embarrassing, how embarrassed this little jerkwad must be. No wonder he blocked me on Twitter for calling him out so many times. And if you missed that video, make sure you check it out. It's very exciting, very funny, and very informative. But enough of that, ladies and gentlemen. If you want to know exactly why Fubo is running and where to expect it to go in the future, if you want to know what my expectations are for Fubo, then stick around, because that's exactly what we're going to be talking about. You don't want to miss this, and we're going to be starting right now. Hey, what's going on? It's Pat from Top Ticker Trades. If you're new here and you want to learn how to use stocks and options to make your portfolio go parabolic, make sure you start now by subscribing and tapping that bell so you never miss an upload. What is going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to yet another video. You're watching the official Fubo channel. That's right, we cover everything that goes on with Fubo. The good, the bad, the ugly. Yes, everything is covered here. So, over the last couple of months, I've told you that maybe the story won't be so pretty for Fubo. But it's not just Fubo, it's every single growth stock. It's been dang near every single growth stock, especially those that, had those big run-ups last year and early on, or coming into early on this year. Unfortunately, for whatever reason, the stock market gods are punishing us, and we've been taking a beating. Fubo's taken a massive beating. But you know what? That's exactly why I love this stock, and that's exactly why I'm going to continue buying as long as it continues to stay at these levels. Now, to be clear, even at the price that it's at today, it did run up quite a bit. I think, 34%? This is still cheap for Fubo if you consider what's going to happen in the future with this stock. I am kind of expecting a continuation. Maybe it'll pull back a little bit and then take off again. I do have a special surprise for you. I have my buddy Chris from Spot On Analysis here today. And before I introduce him to you guys, which a lot of you guys probably already know him, let me tell you this. There's a reason that they call him Spot On Analysis, and that's because his analysis is always spot on. And I can testify to that because, I've been working with this man for a long time, and when he gives you a price target, you can take it to the bank. I'll tell you that much. But Chris, you want to go ahead and introduce yourself to these guys, to the ones that don't know
you? What is up, Ticker family? What is up? We are discussing Fubo TV today. I know those guys are excited. Everybody is feeling resurrected. Not quite back 100%, but definitely on track.
Fubo's been getting beat down. Now, this is a stock that had a lot of momentum behind it, to say the least. You know, last year, this thing was a beast. It was a killer. I mean, it's a stock that you definitely wanted to be in. I can't remember right off the top of my head exactly where it went. I've been holding for quite a long time. I want to say it hit somewhere, you know, in the $60 range. However, you know, it saw some bad days. And it's been getting beat down. It's heavily shorted. For those of you that have been living under a rock for the past, several months, it's not just Fubo. And it hasn't been just Fubo. There's been plenty of good stocks that have been taking a beating. To give you just a few examples, Arrival, Palantir, ChargePoint. I mean, several good stocks. These are those fancy growth stocks that were really kicking tail earlier. Well, now they've been taking a beating, and there's several reasons for that. We're not really gonna get into that right now. I've got other videos that do explain that if you're interested. Before we got any news on what was reported during their earnings, we saw that the stock started running up, and we saw this with several other stocks that were due to report earnings at close today or after market hours. So that in itself wasn't really an indicator that maybe Fubo was going to beat earnings. As a matter of fact, I think the expectations were that, you know, they weren't going to do so well today. These were some very big earnings, okay? And I'm just going to kind of go through them very quickly. They reported a record first quarter revenue of $119.7 million, which is up 135% year over year. This also beats the street consensus of $103.8 million. Over 590,000 subs now. That's up 105% year over year. That's freaking amazing. Advertising revenue was up 206% year over year to $12.6 million. The average revenue per user up 28%. How do you like that? Advertising revenue per user has gone up 57%. These are crazy numbers, guys. Crazy. Okay. Now, typically, we don't see this kind of growth until the fourth quarter from Fubo. This is actually the first time we've seen these types of numbers in the first quarter. What exactly does that tell us? Well, it's telling us that, you know, what Cathie Wood has been saying this entire time. These cord cutters, they're coming for Fubo. I mean, I don't know why, but they really like it. They love it. Now, guys, let me tell you this. Once the gambling side of things really takes off, I believe this stock will take off. And what I find really interesting is that there's already an analyst saying that he sees a 200% upside in the stock. I do not think that this is outrageous or out of reach for Fubo stock. I think this is definitely possible. I see this happening. I'm not going to say very soon, but I see it happening soon enough. So this is something that we're going to cover in just a second, but I feel like I'm kind of hogging the microphone here, and I know Chris has a lot to say. By the way, Chris has a whole series out on Fubo. I think you guys could learn a lot from him, and there is a link to his channel and his latest video in the description below if you guys are interested. But I think I'm going to let him take over and tell you guys a little bit about his series, the work he's been doing, and about the video that he just dropped tonight.
Well, Pat, you were right. I did release initial video today. What I did was just kind of went over the presentation and got everybody caught up. I don't do a lot of jumping around. I stay really kind of close-knit. I feel like I want to know a whole lot about a few stocks, then nothing about a bunch of stocks. So you'll see a lot of YouTubers jump around, and that may work for some channels, and you can always go to those channels for that.
Right.
But I like to, yeah, and I like to focus. I like to jump around too. So I got some of my favorite YouTubers I go jump to. When I want to know something different. But I feel like you can really specialize in a few small select stocks and really understand them. So I did put out an initial series on them where I went in and I just tore apart the whole company and put it back together, and we built the model. And this is all public. I do it right there in front of their face. I usually go behind closed doors and kind of like a mad scientist, and I got the beakers and with the smoke coming out. But this time I did it in public. They just released Q1 today. Impressive, but I've got higher expectations, and I'll get into that.
What?
But yeah, if these guys, I mean, you put it into perspective, and they were trading at $60 what, a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
They dropped the record-shattering numbers today that blew away not only their record, but most of Wall Street's analysts' expectations by wide margin, and they're trading at a third of that. So you definitely got an imbalance there. So what we'll do is look at it, take the 8Q. We're going to tear it all apart again, Pat, and put it back together and reevaluate the model.
All right.
So today was just an initial. We're going to hit the ground running tomorrow. We're going to take all of the financial documents in the first quarter. We're going to tear them all apart, go through all the good stuff. I'll hit all the highlights, recalibrate the model, put it back, and we're going to get ready to go again for Q2. So we had a few, you know, questions. Some people was down. I had a guy I was talking with in my comments, and he was down. He said, man, this thing's dead in the water. It's not coming back. I listened to a lot of what my subscribers say, and if I feel like, you know, they're kind of leaning towards, you know, not feeling good about the company, I'll do a video to try to help them through. So I was able to do two videos, one about understanding volatility as it just really specific to FUBO, and another one about understanding dips. There's so many people, you know, I get irritated with the rocket ship. I put the rocket ship up, but you got to use the rocket ship with care. So we talk about what is a good dip, what is a bad dip, when to go in, when to sit out, and understand that it is okay to sit out. You don't have to have fear of missing out on everything. You know, this is a large stock market, thousands and thousands of securities. You don't have to feel like you have to do anything. So doing nothing sometimes is the best thing to do. So I got a video about that and added with the volatility video that they can always go to, that won't ever be outdated, that will always be right there for them, be true. And if they ever kind of waver in the future, they can always go back and, you know, rewatch it. It's short. These series are 10 minutes or less is my goal, but you know how excited I can get when I start talking about security. So that's the goal moving forward. So they can go check out the initial one tonight, just the preview, and we just build on it. I have a lot of people come in the middle of a series and didn't see video one and just started jumping to the conclusions. And I'm like, hey, man, we're actually on part 7. So if you want to go back and catch up, we love to have you. So that's how I roll over there. I just kind of stay close niche. Now, on the weekend, I do get into some conspiracy stuff. So all bets off on the weekend.
Wait, conspiracies. I know there's conspiracy stuff about one particular company whose name I won't mention, but is there conspiracy stuff about FUBO?
No, I did have, I mean, we went through, and this is a case, this is an example. We went through the 10K, and I finished in 8. I wanted to make it 9, but I promised 8, so I had to stop it at 8. I really wanted to do 9 once I got going. But this one on the quarterly report, I just told all the subscribers, look, we don't know how long this is going to go. We're going to go as long as it takes, and we're just going to enjoy it every step of the way. A lot of people, you know, like to sit back and hit the highlights, especially, you know, you don't hear a lot of stuff from companies between Q1 and in between the quarters, unless it's bad, you know, right. So, or they signed a major deal or something. But so it's the quiet period, the dead period, and we have time to sit back without any pressure and just kind of go through what management is saying. A lot of people are blindsided by that, but you know, not my subscribers. We go through it. Every company I do, we go through the whole statement. So this guy comes on and says, well, you know, they have a lawsuit. Did you know that? Did you know that? And I'm like, yeah, I think that's in like part 4. I mean, are you like in class or are you just kind of popping up out of the blue? Like, where did you check in at? And it's like, oh, I'm so sorry. Let me catch up. So I always tell people, yeah, you know, and I will, like, if I drop a FUBO today or tomorrow, I would automatically assume you've watched the previous 15 because my whole channel is integrated and all related together. So it's like a soap opera story. So we go through and it's cumulative. It's not, I don't jump around, you know, unless it's a conspiracy show or one of my, you know, offshoot shows. I let them know in the beginning, hey, we just having fun here. I haven't researched any of this. Let's just hit it. But outside of that, you know, it's all business. It's all legit research, and we run numbers, and you know, we try to hit them.
So, all right. So earlier you said that you said these numbers didn't quite meet your expectations, or I mean, what were you expecting out of FUBO?
We haven't gone through. I want to go through the quarterly financial statements first. I want to take my subscribers through it, the one that are interested in it. And it's about, I would say, about 150 now. And that's fine. If it's small enough like that, you know, I can get in and answer questions pretty quickly. But if you go back and look at the initial series, we've already had this priced into the model. Ooh. Nothing changes with us. We got to go and find out if anything changes that. But it's, you know, initially from the outside looking in, based on what David was talking about today, we're still where we are. You know, okay. We've got our CAGR at, well, I've got my CAGR at 21, you know, percent. So we'll see how this goes at the end of the year, or see if we can derive any of this. I know in Q2 or 3, I may have to update it to take in the gambling aspect of it. But, you know, I have to see what the impact of the advertising. That's one of my favorite things about today is the subscribers and the advertising. I mean, these guys, I get asked all the time, what's the difference between these guys? Why not YouTube TV? Why not, you know, Netflix? The thing is, they are so dependent on subscribers, where FUBO can actually, I think it was 7-8%, you know, growth in just the advertising, because they have natural breaks in all of the sports footage.
Right. Yeah.
So these, I mean, they are able to just make a killing and not be offended, because all sports fans know you have timeouts and intermissions and breaks, and you can just slide in a commercial right there, and they won't even get offended. So, but if you try that on Netflix, they'll be like, wait a minute, why am I paying you a subscription fee? I still got to watch commercials. So they are able to grow subscribers, advertising, and with gambling. And with the gambling, they're going to have all of these odds makers and bookkeepers advertising mm-hmm. with them. I mean, this is just going to be Pandora's box opening. It's just exciting just to see how this is going to unfold. So I'm very bullish. 2 weeks ago, I told them I recommended a lot of my subscribers to tell you, you know, all of my predictions and price points, they stay up 24/7. I don't have to, you know, crawfish. Of course, you know, no one's right 100% of the time, but I recommended a strong buy on these guys. I got them at a price point of 47, I believe, off the top of my head.
Nice.
And that's with 25% safety factor built in. You know, I'm a fundamentalist. I got to have a margin of safety in there. So I feel pretty good about them. I'm patient. I'm not in any hurry. And I told my subscribers, I said, hey, if you've got 3 years to wait, I think this can be a good idea for you. But if you're in here, you're a technical analyst, and you're trying to, you know, pop something out the park real quick and get out, this may not be the thing for you. You know, sit down. Like I told them in there, I said, come in, close the door, sit down, and shut up. Exactly. And watch your portfolio grow. So
exactly.
But unlike some other companies that we've looked at, you can kind of see what these guys got going, understand it. They break it down. I'm not even in the TV industry or know anything about it. I came in cold turkey, and I automatically can see the potential and figure out what's going on. Unlike some other, we just won't even go there.
I know what you're saying. But I feel like, and we've talked about this before, you kind of connect to this company because you understand them based on, I guess you connect with them based on your personal life a little bit.
Yeah, I like to gamble. And when I say gamble, I don't really think you can call it gambling if you gamble $100 a month. I mean, I'm not, you have guys obviously betting $5,000-$6,000 a game. I have $100 a month gambling budget. That's my vice. I don't do drugs or anything, so, you know, I got to do something.
Yeah.
But I have TV service. And one thing I can't stand is paying for channels I don't watch. And these guys, you know, once this is up, I'm looking to move over to FUBO, whether I was covering them or not, because I only watch the sports stuff. And if you're going to go ahead and add gambling to that, and I can watch the TV and gamble. See, one thing, one hidden layer here, Pat, is when you have money on a game, you watch the entire game. You don't even move because you want to see. I mean, I gambled on the Super Bowl, $10. I watched the halftime show and everything. I mean, it was like I didn't want to move. And that was just $10. You multiply that times, you know, thousands of dollars of, you know, of people. And they will be engaged not only in the sporting event because they have money in on it. So I'm just really excited about the direction of this company. And like the guy said, you know, he thinks they're dead. I said, well, you could be right, but then again, you could be wrong. And that's the beauty of the stock market. Everybody has a different assumption and opinion about where this company is going. And I'm bullish on them. So,
I'm extremely bullish.
Got to be bullish.
Yeah, I'm right there with you.
I feel better about them than I have a couple of the other companies I follow.
Oh, I know. Trust me, I know. But with this, not really specifically with Fubo, but I have seen this out of my... some of my subscribers, or at least some people leaving comments. It's like, you know, when stocks are going up, everybody loves them. Everybody loves you. Everybody's, you know, commenting really positive stuff. But the moment that they go down, regardless of the reason, you know, even if nothing's changed for the company fundamentally, but just because the share price is going down, people tend to, you know, kind of lose their minds and forget that we're talking about the stock market here. This is what happens. You know, stocks go up and they go down. They can't just continuously go up.
I think I got that fixed in that volatility show about football. I mean,
you go into more detail about that?
It's the one with the ship on the ocean.
Oh, yeah.
It's a theme off of Vanguard. It's kind of like their theme and their logo. And it's just kind of weathering the storm. And do you get motion sickness? Because if you get motion sickness in the stock market, Fubo is not for you.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, these guys, it's a reason they're selling cheap. It's because you're going to have to take a risk. But with risk comes reward.
Exactly.
And without risk comes no reward.
Exactly.
I mean, it is, what did that guy say? Go get in an index fund, right?
Yeah.
So nobody wanted to be in an index fund.
Yeah, if you don't like volatility, you know, index funds, they'll do well for you.
Right. And it's not for that lion's share of your portfolio. It's not for your retirement. It's speculative. It's that 10, 15, 20% kicker that you need to beat out inflation in your portfolio. You know, as bullish as I am, I don't have my life savings on it.
I'm not even going to lie. I'm going to continue to build my position out even more. I did pick some up this morning. Luckily, you know, when I woke up this morning, I saw that they were at $16 and something cents. And, you know, I had to buy. I pressed that buy button. And thank goodness that I didn't sell any calls. And I'll just be straight up honest with everybody here. I don't trust this market. And I think that we're going to continue seeing, you know, these types of stocks continue to slowly go down. If you'll notice the pattern that we've been seeing here, basically we get a whole bunch of downside, we get a couple or a few green days, and then it's right back to slowly going down, you know.
That's how I got in it. I sold that position in ARDX.
Oh yeah.
And
yeah,
it sat on the sideline, and once I finished my analysis of them. And that's the thing about it. I'm not sitting around telling somebody this thing's going to the moon and leaving them hanging. I have 8 videos to back up what I'm saying. So I'm not pulling stuff out of the air. We build an agenda, we go through it, and then we come back. They're short, easily digestible shows. So it's out there. It's in the public. You know, the veil has been pulled back. So moving forward with this company, my expectations are, if you've watched the volatility show or any of my offshoot tutorials, I expect some excitement to come in to push the stock higher, probably where it has no business being, maybe a little premature, sort of like what happened last year. You know, so that will push people like me to the sideline until it comes back down to reality.
That's when he gets bearish.
Yeah, I'll get bearish when they push me out. And then these guys that are not subscribed to me will say, what's wrong with this company? I hate you guys. I've lost money. Or I'll start getting emails. My average is high. What should I do? And I'm like, hey, you should have subscribed 3 months ago. I don't know what to tell you, but I'll get out. So, and then the stock will go back down, and then the rational people will enter the market again and grow. So, and it's one thing, like I tell them, like a snapshot example. If you have in your mind, and everybody's different, I make a point to tell them, get your own, you know, analysis and assumptions about the company. I'm at 21. If you're more bearish, maybe you're at 15. If you're more bullish, maybe you're at 30. Be that as it may, but know where you are. So when that price point gets above that, I'm at 21. If that price gets to the point to where it's reflecting a CAGR of 30, I'm going to the sideline. And if once I'm not entering back into the market until it gets back at my price point. And all investors have different price points. So, and that's all I preach is understand where you are and why you are there. So, and that's what I preach. That's what I teach. That's what I try to empower, because I like to have really intelligent conversation with my subscribers. It is nothing like arguing with a 3-year-old.
Yeah. You know, we get those kind of people.
Yeah. Yeah. It's like, can we elevate this conversation and have some adult dialogue here about what your position is without attacking you, you attacking me? You
exactly.
know, I have some guys, Pat, you saying this thing's gotten up to 200%. That's your position. I will admit off the record, privately, you know it. I'll say it on your channel. I probably won't say it on mine. I actually think that's not that far outside the realm of possibilities. I can't really say it in public and defend it, because I just did an 8-part series defending 100% upside. But personally, I think it can even go further. They are built like that, because my 100% is not inclusive of the gambling. So exactly. Who knows where this gambling will take it, in particular if they're the only ones with it. So we got to look at DraftKings, look at the competition. But if you have all the subscribers and like 10% of them are with the gambling, I mean, who knows what this thing can do? I think the upside is like unlimited.
Yeah.
With a downside of zero.
Yeah.
So, I'm excited about it. And like I say, nothing is for certain. And these guys do still lose a little money. What we talked about today was they are still losing, but they are losing less and less and less.
Yeah.
So, and they are getting that contribution margin where it needs to be, the subscribers. And one thing about the subscribers, we talk about economics and economies of scale and spreading out fixed costs, is that these costs go down as more subscribers come on. And they are able to upsell these guys and bring them into the family and get more average revenue from them. So you talk about these ARPUs and some of the metrics that this industry is measured by. Again, you can, if we're speaking Greek, you can go catch up in that series and then you can kind of understand what we're talking about. But you know, learn the language of this industry. And I think you can be more educated and more successful. And you won't jump in and out at the wrong times. You will understand your plan. And it's all about executing your plan. Not my plan, not your plan, but your personal plan.
Exactly. So, Chris, one thing I did want to tell these guys is, you know, if they... By the way, so a link to Chris's channel is in the description below if you guys want to... go and subscribe to him real quick if you're not subbed to him already. But one thing you're going to learn on his channel is a little bit about how to construct a model. You want to tell him a little bit about that, Chris?
They can look at it. That thing is like, I get in so much trouble, Pat, on my page. They say, oh, you're rambling. This is so far off my head. What the model is it's a discounted cash flow models where I look at companies, and I get this a lot. If you invested in a company too long, you become intimate with that company where you are not in it for dollars and cents. You are in it emotionally.
Right.
And what a model does is separate that emotion. That model says, do you make money or do you not? And when you do not make money, it is not an investment. It is a hobby, which is fine, but you are not investing if you are emotionally tied to it. Don't mix money and honey.
Yeah.
And what the model does is it takes the emotion out and realizes you come face to face
We're reality.
And as long as you are in reality and you understand these securities, the better off you're going to be. So that's what it does. It helps you to disconnect your emotions. And we have companies, again, we won't mention any names, but these guys will ride this thing to zero. Yeah. And as bullish as I am on FUBO, if David doesn't perform, I'm out. And there's no hard feelings. I'll still drink a beer with him that same day. It's just, I'm out. I'm in here to make money, not to give money away.
And speaking of David, we're going to try to get him on the channel.
I will. I told myself, I said, you know, I will go to New York again. I've been once. I said I'll go again, but I want him to take me serious. So if I get up to 1,000 subs, I'm going to go up there and see if I can get an interview with him.
And we're going to do it. By golly, we're going to do it.
If I told him I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it.
Yeah.
I just doubt I would have to do it this year. But you never know.
Otherwise, we're going to keep calling his phone and saying, hey, man, why don't you do an interview with us?
Well, I tell you what, it'll have to happen before winter, Pat, because I don't want any part of that. You know, we're down here in the South. I don't want any part of New York in the wintertime.
I've been there.
So they may get me to 1,000 subs December 1st. I'm going to say, you know what? Y'all going to have to wait the spring.
Guys, hurry up and get him to 1,000 subs because, you know, we're not trying to travel in the winter. Not to New York. Sorry, New Yorkers, but we're just not doing it. Make sure you smash that like button because we would really appreciate it. It helps us stay motivated and put out more content just like this. For those of you that don't know, normally Chris and I get together on Sundays, every Sunday, and we put out, a little talk show just like this one where we discuss certain stocks. Today, the topic of interest happened to be FUBO because they had earnings. But, you never know what we're going to talk about.
Today was special because it was earnings.
Exactly.
Sunday is fun. I even think we're doing a little sipping.
So, oh, yeah.
I think they'll like the Sunday show.
You will love the Sunday show, fellas and ladies. While I have you here, I wanted to quickly tell you about the brand new First Trade app, available for mobile or PC. The platform will give you access to powerful and easy-to-use tools and allows you to trade with less restrictions. Zero commissions, zero fees, and you can use the first link in the description below to download a free stock today without having to deposit any money. This will greatly help out the channel and is always appreciated. And now, back to your regularly scheduled programming. Congrats, ladies and gentlemen. You've made it to the end of the video. If you like what you watched, make sure you subscribe because I put out videos just like this one every single day. And please do me a favor and smash that like button if I helped you in any way, because it really goes a long way in helping the channel out and keeps me motivated to make videos every single day. Now, there's a lot of work involved, a lot of research, and a lot of time and effort into editing and putting these out daily for you guys. You can subscribe from your screen right now, or if you want to watch one of my other videos, I'm sure YouTube has some good content picked out for you on the left-hand side of your screen now. Thanks for sticking it out with me till the end, and I will see you guys in the next video.